I'm sure from time to time around the game you may have had the odd problem chipping. Well, Callaway may have the answer. I've got Roger Cleveland here with a new golf club, so please tell me what it is and how it works.
Well, it's not a wedge.
It's not a wedge?
Not a wedge. Okay. Not a wedge. But there are some options that you have around the green. One is a good wedge, like a Callaway wedge with nice bounce, and you have to use that. Another option is a hybrid. Okay, because the hybrid has enough loft and it has a wider sole, so you can let it slide and skid along the ground. Okay, but the hybrid's a little awkward sometimes because it's a little longer and you have to stand up and you can't get the feel. This is kind of the answer to both of those. Okay, and it came from the putting world, not from the wedge world, I want you to know. But our head of putting and design, Austin Rawlinson, cooked this one up. And it's a pitcher, okay, a chipper. It's called Exact, has a wide sole. It has a wonderful alignment, which is terrific, because a lot of people, when they pitch, they can't align very well. It has plenty of loft, 37 degrees. It has a white hot insert, which has wonderful feel, just like the putters, okay? But what's neat, it has the tank system of weighting, which is counterweighting, so it wants to just swing, okay? And your alignment, it has the length of a putter. So when you address the shot, okay, you use your putter alignment system. So whatever you get over it, it's 35 inches. You take your putter grip and you just swing it like so, and it's really easy to use. And the force comes from the same putter force that you would putt.
You just take a normal putting swing, if you like, for
that's right.
That.
And you can use it from quite a bit away from the green.
Yeah, how far back do you think you go? Because I had a little go around the fringes here. It's great. I pop it over the edge, don't you?
I've seen people use it from 80 yards.
Really?
Okay. Yeah. That's quite a swing from 80 yards. It's quite a putt, but it's used quite effectively, and that's a little more force that might have gone in.
Yeah, so as we say, it's 37 degrees, so that's around about, what,
eight iron?
8 iron, something like
that.
Yeah,
so it's like a chip and run, but an 8 iron has a fairly, you know, small sole, so it's a little less forgiving. The key to this is because it's so wide and so forgiving. There's a radius on this, so it matches the radius of your arc of a putt, so it's quite easy.
All right, do you want to give me a show and see if I can see how I get
absolutely.
On?
Absolutely, sure. So just...
Is there anything particular about the setup that you
No, just like
about?
A putter, and just let it swing. That's it.
That's it?
Yeah,
that's
just like that. Just like that.
And see, it's a much sort of softer feel than a wedge. Is that?
That's the white hot insert. Yeah.
I mean,
it has score lines as well, so it's going to grab the ball a little bit. But it's a beautiful white hot feel.
Is there any reason why you went for the white hot insert rather than having a steel face?
Well, it's part of the Odyssey family. And we wanted some nice feel around the green. That also, because it's square, it's easy to line up with the vertical. So, and that's simple. That's going to be in. Ooh,
just missed that.
Close. Pretty easy, isn't it?
It is very easy to hit. I mean, that's the simplicity of it. I mean, if you are struggling with anything around the green, this just takes everything, all the possibilities of disaster out, really, doesn't it?
Well, the disaster is not understanding how to use the sole. This, you keep that beautiful putting stroke. You just keep your arc or your putting stroke, and it's as simple as anything.
Now, I've been having a good play around with this. It is very good on sort of short range stuff. You can actually sort of take a longer swing at it, and you can get maybe sort of 80, 100 yards out of it. For some of the longer chips, so I mean, if I'm going here to a hole maybe sort of 40 feet away, you can hit that type of shot, it will go in the air probably about half of the way and run out. But really, this is probably best in that sort of 20 to 40 feet range, because that's sort of the limit of your natural putting stroke. So you get a nice sort of feel in it. And you can sort of alter the position of the hands a little bit, have them further ahead if you want to keep it down. So there is ability to manipulate the shot a lot, but really what this club is about is just making that nice, smooth swinging stroke. The ball jumps up, runs out, and takes all the risk out of the shot. I speak to Callaway, they've suggested that you probably wouldn't replace a wedge with this club unless you really didn't want to speak to them at all, because you will need that to get out of the bunkers. You will need those wedges if you want a slightly higher shot. But the suggestion maybe is to take one of the long irons out of your bag. And really, if you do need this club a lot around the green, then it's probably going to save you more shots than a long iron would. And maybe you cover the gap by picking a hybrid or something, which is going to cover the gap at the top of the bag. But certainly this could be a valuable club in your arsenal for anybody who has a few little jitters around the edge of the green. That's all for me today. Let me know what you think of this club. Please leave some comments below. And for more reviews on all Callaway equipment, check out the website at golfalot.com.